welcome back to Dracon's Place, Dark Souls 2. Alright, so now that we have our handy-dandy shortcut, we're going to use it to progress further in the level. Now, I am not going to go up on that raised platform that we ran next to, that the fireball thrower. Not going to go up there, do that yet. Instead, I'm gonna go this way because I'll do better this way. Alright. Item in the corner, green blossom. Whoa. I'm dead. There. I got extremely unlucky with that one. Okay, since I died for the first time, let's talk about death. So, in Dark Souls 1, death meant you started to hollow, and you started gaining hollowing levels. However, not much happened to you. In this one, you can already see my health bar has been chipped down a little bit. A little hard to see. But that's the effect of hollowing in this game. You start to lose your health down to... down until you reach... ...50%. Now, Dark Souls 3 doesn't have any such system. Demon Souls, you lost 50% of your health. But, early on, you would get a ring called the Cling Ring, which mitigated a lot of that. Crap! I hate the Estus in this one. I'm still going off my instincts in for like Dark Souls 3 on Estus usage. Not in this game. Nope. Estus, very slow animation. Health does not come back immediately. And now you can really see the effect of my health bar. The first death is almost nothing. Later ones mean a lot more. Also, there's no kick in this game. There's a weird... There it is. Guard break. Oh my. It's very, very hard to do, in my opinion. There it is. Alright. Yeah, yeah. Very, very deliberate. Like, you have to really, really mean to guard break. Get back, Stephanie. So I'm having extreme problems with this little trap. I've never actually died before on it. Okay. Great soul arrow, large soul, blue wooden shield. All those are still totally usable. Yep, and that's the other thing. In this game, you have trap chests. Like that one. Use Ferrous Lockstone? Definitely. And I'm already starting to look like beef jerky. So this one is a very good lockstone. You get two chests, a titanite slab, and the Florinthy ring, which is an immediate thing to put on. It ups your stamina recovery quite substantially. Why'd I guard break? Winged spear. Attacking, so they're telling you. So that guy's lying about that. Life ring, large titanite shard. So if I wanted to, I could plus four this thing. Oh. Yeah, liar ahead. And if it was a real wall, I think he placed it so close you can't actually use it. Which is a serious problem. Oh, I almost forgot. We also got the life ring, which means we get a tad bit more health. All right.
Traveling all alone in these treacherous times.
Yes, I am.
Well, I hope you have a very good reason. Oh, hogwash. Who am I to judge? My name is Pate.
Hi, Pate.
I journey hither and thither on a sort of treasure hunt, you might call it.
Okay.
Be careful out there. There's talk of unsavory bandits who prey upon travelers like yourself.
Oh.
Oh, yes. You'll be cautious if you go any farther. There's treasure in there for certain, but the entrance locks from behind.
So he warns us of a trap.
It's the same design earlier, and it's the same contraption, I'm sure. I was with this warrior, you see, and he insisted that he go inside first.
Oh.
The rather brusque fellow tried to swipe the loot for himself, but it trapped him inside. I still have the gent's ring. I do hope he wasn't harmed. I'll leave this one to you. I'm worried about what might be inside.
Why do you have his ring?
I'll leave this one.
All right. Get backstabbed. Pull a soldier helm. Throwing knife. All right. Yeah, another change in this one compared to like other Souls games. Aromatic ooze. Has to do with the illusionary walls. In this one, you press the action button rather than the regular, you hit it with your weapon. Sorcerer's staff, amber herb. Those guys. Try low by way enemy. Oh, so you're telling me to plunge attack Pate?
You managed to escape. I hope that brave warrior didn't come a cropper either. Be careful out there. There's talk of unsavory bandits who prey upon travelers like yourself. Oh, but you should take this.
White signed soapstone.
It allows undead to call out for help to one another across the fissures between worlds. With luck, somebody will lend you a hand.
Alright.
Well, I see you. I hope that right. Be careful.
Yeah. So it's very unclear if, like, he's tricking you into trusting him, and this was his trap, and he was going to loot your body, that's what happened to the guy he's talking to, or if he's being 100% honest about all this stuff. Very, very interesting stuff with him. Oh, and I got a life gem. Alas, nothing happened. Large soul lost on deck. Giant butthole. clever guy. All right. Light crossbow. Let's see if this works. Gonna have to come back to make that jump. He gave me a life gem. Alright, and I still got my Estus too. Mailbreaker, infantry helm. Winged spear. Hollow soldier armor. Alright, let's go back up and around. Attempt to get that item. Honestly, what we're trying to do at this stage is to work our way around, unlock the next shortcut. Soul of a Nameless Soldier and a torch. Someone just fell to their death. Another life gem. Homeward bones. Okay, that guy glitched the heck out. I don't mind, I got a free kill, but... that was generally weird. Gotcha. Amber her. I really need to unlock that shortcut. There we go. So now I have the shortcut. Hollow soldier leggings. Large leather shield. I believe. Yeah. It's a little bit better than our current one. A little bit lighter, too. Touching a bunch of random pools of blood. A lot of people die to that. It's a very good trap. Let's see. I don't want any accidents. All right. Time to take on our first boss. Yeah, I know, I could do the Pursuer optional fight. But I want to be as strong as possible for that one. So one interesting thing with this game is that characters, like Pete here, so like other games you can summon them. One of the big differences though in Dark Souls 2 is they need to survive fights. They need to survive fights so that you can advance their quest line. So normally I would do things solo, but because you need them to finish quest lines, why with the vignetting? The letterboxing, fine. It makes it different. But the vignetting. Alright, let's do it. The Last Giant. Of course, I know his name already. It hasn't shown up yet. It's honestly not a bad intro cinematic. And it's like some of the... Like this is even cooler if you've played through the game and fully understand. You're doing good, Pete. Oh, don't miss. So he just ripped off his arm. I thought I had that. Doing good, Pete. Got him. Good job, Pete. Soul of the Lost Last Giant and the Soldier Key. The big thing there is the soldier's key. Yeah, that one doesn't open with the soldier key. Yeah, you have to drop down in there, and to do that, you really do need the silver cat. Back to Majula. Or do I want to do that side air? I think I have enough stats. But yeah, we'll go back to Majula, level up, and then we're going down in opening up a bunch of other doors. First one will actually get me my next weapon, which is going to be super duper important.
Bearer, listen.
Alright, I'm going to put a point into Dex. Let's get some more endurance. What's my... Alright. Let's get some adaptability up in there. And some Vit. There we go. Whole lot of stuff there. Alright. There we go. Starting to even out my character a little bit. Soon enough, I'm just going to have to go crazy, though, pumping strength. So that way I can use the first Ultra Greatsword. Yeah. In the original version of Dark Souls 2... there was a problem with durability where if you hit a body, like just a dead body, you would end up taking out like double the durability, which is insane. Use soldier key. Got black firebomb. Good counter. Got him. Torch. Yeah, that's... This area is just stupid, stupid dark. I think it's a little bit brighter for you guys. These guys are a little hardier than the last ones. Amber Herb, Green Blossom. Alright, I got an invader. Me? Okay. Vanquished. Oof. Human effigy. That guy can be a serious problem. Alright. Got a large soul. You coming to party? Oh boy. I should have used the life gem. Alright. Human effigy. I have a whole bunch of items to read. Gotcha. Alright, so I got the weapon I was after. Some more souls. Human effigy. Hold on. Alright, let's keep going. Only one more room to clear. Now let's see. Seed of a tree of giant. I didn't notice there was actually a seed there. And that's super cool. I actually got it because that's kind of rare. Alright. Now, while we're here, let's actually go. There's another way that's fairly short. Yeah, there's three spots that you can open using that key. Firebomb. A second. So that was the second one right there. Leads to this chest. Ring of Restoration. Gradually restores HP. Totally worth it at this stage in the game. Well, partially because I only have four rings. was not exactly a sacrifice. Grand Lance. So that, yeah, that guy will just hang out over there. He's guarding that door. Amber Herb. Alright. Let's see, can I take him? Totally. Got him. Ah, just souls. Too bad. Produce the symbol of the king, so we can't open that yet. Malincha.
You're strange to be
a little bit.
We get to strangers these days. Everybody's gonna run off.
Alright. I have to exhaust her dialogue to get her to go back to Majula.
Lake's been up a pile of rubble since the war long, long ago. And the giants was the same. Seems like the battles would never end. I found myself a nary place to sleep. I swear I'll keep all meetings right with me. You may travel night, but methinks you bear a burden of your own. They say these trees grew from the remains of the giants.
Here we go. Alright. Oh, and she's gone. Perfect. Alright, that means she's in Majula now, which will make it much easier to buy the few good things she has later on. Yep, so she's right here now.
Oh, you again?
Hi, Malincha.
Come on, he's on the chink for you.
So I don't know if she actually changes her shop at this point. Looks like that is a new.
Lovely.
Okay. So how many shards do I have? I have two. Alright, so I have a bunch of items for you. Key to the soldier's door in the forest of the fallen giants. A fort was erected in the forest to face the giants, but now the soldiers are lost and hollow. They are enfeebled, but not without honor, and continue to steadfastly defend their country. Alright, now what else do we get? Black Firebomb is just a stronger version. Utilizes a powerful explosive developed in the fallen kingdom of Forcia. Black fire bombs can cause harm to their owners when misused, and Forcian law defines stringent standards for their safe storage. Throwing knife, nothing on there. Aromatic ooze, which was called sticky white stuff originally. Not a great name. Alright. Alright, magic. Yeah, nothing really good there. For lore reasons. Soul of the Lost, or Last Giant. Soul of the surviving giant who is bound below the forest of the giants. The lord of the giants, who have brought wrack and ruin to the entire kingdom, was said to have been felled by an unknown warrior. His beaten and broken remains were then dragged beneath the stronghold, where he was sealed away. Nothing on there. Nothing. 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 Here we go. A lump of something obtainable from a giant tree makes enemies react to invaders. When giants fell, the tree grew into great trees. When giants fell, they grew into great trees. Death is not then, for anything that's ever lived, ever once lived, remains a part of the great cycle of regeneration. But what if those outside of the cycle? I love just like little cheeky dialogue like that where you're like, huh? Alright. Anyways, I am going to wrap this one up here. Next time, we'll continue through the Forest of Fallen Giants, take on the next boss. So I'll see all of you later. Bye!